Good evening. The few seconds that it took for me to get that mic done, etc., you are all watching me and you've already formed some opinion about me. That's the beauty of human nature. 10 seconds, it's all that it takes to form an opinion about somebody. And in about 5 minutes, you have either confirmed or rejected that opinion. And this, even when the person is not talking to you. I was not talking to you. And yet, just by observing, looking at my body language, looking at my expression, looking at what I was doing with these boys and girls, you were going ahead and forming an opinion about me. It is a very, very well-known fact that what we don't speak by words conveys a lot. I'm sure all of you are aware that they have the statistics. I don't know how they got it. 55% of your communication intake is visual, they say. Even the balance 45% is not the words that I express. 38%, they say, is the tone in which I speak. And only 7% is the words that I speak. Okay, somebody has given us those statistics. But do we actually, you know, work on them? We all want to put up a good impression. We all want to, you know, make a good image in front of people and things of that sort. But how much effort do we put into this? It's amazing. When I went into this history for the first time, I was quite surprised to find that over the centuries, while a lot of research was done in so many other aspects of behavioral sciences, nonverbal communication or body language was hardly given any importance at all. Perhaps Charles Darwin was one of the first people to really give us some deeper insights into nonverbal communication. But as you know, because he became more famous or more notorious for his theory of evolution, that overshadowed this, and hardly anybody even knows the extensive work that he has done in this area. The other person who has done very pioneering work in nonverbal communication is not a psychologist, not a cognitive scientist, it is a zoologist. Desmond Morris was a zoologist who studied primates, and he kept studying apes, monkeys, orangutans, gorillas. And one fine day he said, why not study this one ape who's got everything else that the other apes have got, except that he is naked. He doesn't have fur all over his body. And he started studying human beings the way he would study the other primates. And obviously people were not very happy. It's not a very complimentary thing to be connected to our cousins. So not many people were very happy with him. And that was another reason that a lot of pioneering work done by him, you know, went off. Today, we do acknowledge the importance of nonverbal communication somewhere on the periphery. But there's very little that we actually do anything about. Take the simplest thing, that is a smile. I don't know how many people are aware of the fact that a smile is a learned phenomenon. It is not something that comes naturally to human beings. Again, extensive research has been done on this to show that only those people who see others smiling, they learn how to smile. And smiling is something, the more you practice, the more you start smiling. If you have come across somebody whom you watch and say, hey, this man has got a very smiling face, or that lady has got such a charming smile, it's not that God has been more kind to those people. They have practiced. They've actually practiced smiling. And that is why today they are called people with smiling faces. And many of us practice frowning. And then we say that this person has got a frowning face or whatever it is. Starting with something like simple like a smile. The other thing about nonverbal communication is the eyes. They say that eyes express more than any other part of the body. And yet, there are so many of us who do not make eye contact. You will be meeting a person and shaking hands with him, and he'll be looking through you or over you or under you. You'll be talking to somebody and that person would not be making an eye contact. The person talking will not be making eye contact. Instead of talking to you people, I'll be talking to the trees or to the floor. Such an important aspect, which, as I said, these are all learned phenomena. All you have to do is to go on practicing. And you'll realize that good, warm, steady eye contact will get you far more friends than any other form of flattery or anything of that sort. But as I said, the question is, do we really practice and do we really put it into use? In fact, when it comes to observation and analysis of body language, people also have this question, and they have been asking this question that, you know, are men better at observation of body language or are women better? I have done some research on that and I thought I'll share it with you. Women are very good observers of body language. And that's the reason why I tell all my married friends, when you want to bluff to your wife, don't do it when she's standing in front of you. Go out of the house and call her up. Or better still, send her a text message. Your chances of getting away are far better. On the other side, I tell people that men are excellent observers of body. Full stop. Yet, the fact remains, all of us can actually work on this as a wonderful tool to build better relationships, to spread some sort of joy around, to make our quality of life better, and it really does not cost anything at all. Another aspect of non-verbal communication which is very, very neglected is the sense of touch. So many of us are very reticent about touch. We start off with telling our little children about what is good touch and bad touch. But somewhere we leave them with the message that it's all bad touch. Be extremely careful. We don't tell them about the good touch part of it. We always caution them about the bad touch. And that's the reason why. Because you may have one odd person who may be giving you what we call as a bad touch, we lose out on the 9 other people or 99 other people who can give you good touch. Science has proved that touch is an essential part of the growth of a human being. The amount of love, affection, security, warmth that you can feel, the way you can progress in life, the way you can handle challenges, a lot of it can be bolstered if we keep getting a lot of touch. And somewhere along the line, that's another area which is sadly very, very neglected. On the one side, we need to understand, observe, analyze body language of other people. There are people who talk, whether it's to one person or whether it's to a group, and they do not listen with their eyes. Because 55% of communication intake is visual. I am doing the verbal talking. You all are sitting and watching me. Am I listening to you is the question. If I am observing you carefully, I can listen through my eyes and make out what is it that appeals to you, what is it that bores you, what is it that catches your attention, what is it you agree with and what is it that you disagree with. Whether it's a one-to-one communication or a public speech, it doesn't matter. Basically, that's what it's all about. The more we can learn to start observing body language of people, the easier it becomes to build bridges and to build relationships. Equally important, or maybe more important, is to be able to improve your own body language. As I told you, first impressions are formed very, very easily. How often do I take the trouble of creating a good first impression in front of people? Am I conscious of the fact that when I am presenting myself for the first time to somebody, what sort of an impression am I creating on that person? The way I am dressed, the way I am standing, the way I am smiling, the way I am making eye contact, everything matters to the other person, because the other person is going ahead and forming an opinion. Many a time I'd like to also share with you what we talk about as gut feeling or instinct. You look at a person and say, somehow I don't seem to like this guy. Why? What's wrong with him? I don't know, but I get the creeps looking at him. The reason is his body language, more often than not. We are not able to explain that. So we say it is an instinct, it's a gut feeling or whatever it is. But actually it is your subconscious mind telling you that there is something wrong with the body language of this person. And yet we are not aware of the type of image that we are giving out to others. There's a lot of difference between what I am and what I project to others. I can say a lot verbally. I can talk a lot verbally. But that's only 8%. The rest of it, the more important part of it, which I want to convey to people, somehow doesn't get conveyed to the people at the right time and in the right way. And I don't even realize this is what I am doing. Am I making that effort to ensure that I am giving out the correct image to people? And if I don't do it, and I say, why is it people are not making friends, or why is it people are not responding to me, or why is it I'm not able to convince somebody about my genuine thoughts or ideas or whatever it is? It works wonders, I tell you. This is something which I have been observing, and I'm sure many of you have been observing. There is so much to be done in this area, but hardly anything is done. Neither are children taught in schools and colleges on this aspect of non-verbal communication, nor do we learn on our own later on, nor do we actually practice and sharpen those skills. We do not do it because we feel that this is something which comes by itself. As I told you about the smile, that is not true at all. In fact, I was just thinking the other day, you know, one of the worst ways that you can put down a person, if somebody were to ask you, hey, I think you know Ali, what do you have to say about him? You know what's the worst thing that you can say about me to that stranger? Ali, I better not say anything. You can swear and say, Ali, I never said a word against you. But there you are, the damage is done. If you had said that Ali is a person who cheats in money matters, the other person may say, anyway, I'm not going to have money dealing, so what? How does it matter? But when you say, when you leave the person with that suspense, that is when the person doesn't know what to do. And that is what happens in body language. As I told you earlier, it's extremely difficult, unless you are an accomplished actor, it's very, very difficult for you to tell lies through body language. And that is to your advantage. If I am a good observer of body language, I can make out when the person is telling lies, when the person is trying to flatter me, when the person is trying to impress me or anything of that sort. Yet, we get carried away by the words of people. People express in verbal language something which I take it for granted that, okay, this is what it is all about. A simple incident I wanted to share with you when I was talking to you about touch was, there was this library where the librarian was told that all members who come to collect or give a book, those with even number, touch them, shake hands or pat them or make good eye contact, smile at them, and delay giving them the book. Make them wait. All those with the even numbers, don't make eye contact, don't touch them, don't even smile at them, but give them instant service. And at the end of a certain period, a survey was done. People were asked, How good is this librarian and how good are the services of this library? Can you guess? All the first category people said excellent service. When the librarian purposely delayed giving them their books. And in the second case, people said, no, service was not good. That is the impact. That is what we need to understand. We can all do it at any age. Of course, as in any other issue, the earlier you start, the better it is and the more you can work on it. But these are some of the things which I personally feel don't need any age or anything of that sort. It doesn't even need you to study a lot of theory or this or that or anything of that sort. All you need to do is to practice, be conscious about these sort of things, practice and go on improving yourself steadily. You will notice that there will be a tremendous change in your life, in your relationships, because I am a strong believer that nothing can improve your life or nothing can make you as happy as good interpersonal relationships. And the basis, the foundation of good interpersonal relationships is the body language that you express and how well you can understand the body language of other people. So please go ahead, practice and see how your life improves. Thank you.